Yo, it's been a fucking while, boys. It's been a while. Definitely my fault. The last session you've seen was about 2 weeks ago, and that was me attempting three. No, that was me actually getting 305 to lie. I have since then attempted 310. Failed. Definitely mentally wasn't there. Don't know why I sent it, but I did. Hey ho. Body wasn't there. I just need some recovery, man. I don't know what's wrong with me. I'm trying to pee out every week. It's a bad idea. I've got more space, guys. You know, I'm in a new car. I bought a new car. A bit more spacious. You know what I mean? I feel good, mate. But yes, it's been a while, man. And I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry. But I'm back on my bullshit. I have recorded, like, fucking probably a collective hour's worth of content on my camera in the last kind of 2 weeks. And it's been across multiple sessions with different days with Mike, Joe, Luke, etc. But we've just been more really focused on the training that we haven't recorded as much. I hope you're all well. I'm good. What else?
I'm Slim Shady, yes, I'm the real Shady. All you other Slim Shadys are just imitating. So won't the real Slim Shady please stand up? Please stand up. Please stand up.
I did that. I'm just going to skip over that and pretend I didn't do that, though. Yeah, all right. Just pretend that didn't fucking happen. And in bigger news, I am officially competing in the single lift British Championships in 4 days. Today's Tuesday. I'm working tomorrow, so I'm at work Wednesday. I'm at work Thursday. And then I'll be travelling to Manchester Friday morning to weigh in and then stay in Manchester throughout the day and overnight, ready to compete on Saturday morning. This is extremely, extremely sudden, unexpected. And quite frankly, I'm a little nervous. Reason is I have never competed before. I've done bits of strongman, kind of local events, council events, and there's been crowds, but never big crowds. But additionally, I've never competed. I've never followed commands. It's all new to me. I've never practiced pause bench. I've never practiced comp standard bench. I've always done kind of, you know, just gym lifts and so on. And yeah, I've gone super heavy. You know, 305 kilo in wraps is fucking incredible. You know, handful of men in the world will ever do that.
Ooh, you're hard showing off.
But comp is a different world. So I have officially entered a comp on 5 days' notice, having never trained the lift at a comp standard. Did prep last night, so basically got confirmed yesterday, and then went to the gym last night. Did pause bench up to about 5 kilograms over my opener, 2.5 kilograms over my planned opener. Moved it really easy, felt good, felt great. Managed to do well with the commands all in. Mike was pretty proud of me, which is a good sign. And yeah, I'm now 4 days out. So really, I should be resting now. That's what a normal powerlifter would do. But they also have a much longer prep than me. Don't get me wrong, in a sense, I have had a similar style prep, probably not to the same degree of volume, but I've been maxing out every week. My joints are sharp, my body's fucked. So, yeah, excited, slightly nervous, but that's okay. It's okay to be nervous. At the same time, I also completely believe in myself. I know what I'm capable of. So I know that I'm going to fucking smash this shit. The British record is mine on 5 days' notice. I'm going to come in having never done a comp, never prepared before, never done anything like that. Never really practiced comp bench in my life. And I'm going to come in and take the British record. That's the plan. But I just wanted to check in with you guys and say hello, give you an update. I love you guys. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned. Again, thank you so much, as always, to Silverback Gymwear, to Applied Nutrition. Go and get your discounts. The links are in the description of this video and also on my socials. Baker20 at checkout Applied Nutrition and follow the link on Silverback through my description and bios to get yourself 10% off your order. Thank you so much for my sponsors, man. Without you guys, obviously, like I always say, none of this is possible. And I suppose one thing I do need to tell you guys, which I haven't told nobody, is I'm officially taking a break from work. So in about 13 days, I leave my job for 12 months. I'm taking a 12-month career break to completely commit myself and focus on my content and focus on my lifting. I want to be the best in the world. I want to be the world number one in bench press. And to do so, I'm going to need to be able to fund that lifestyle. And funding that lifestyle is going to be through content. It's going to be through bringing you guys the best content that I can. And to be able to do that, I need to be focused on it and to have time to do so. So like I said, man, my working life is done soon. And I'm going to be committed to my passion, which is this. I'm super excited. So thank you to everyone that supports me, watches a video, shares a video, likes a video, buys anything through a code of mine. It means the world. It really does. And let's fucking get it, man. Let's make history. I'm ready, bro. Saturday can't come soon enough. I'm excited. I'm nervous, but it's mine. Do it, Luke.
Do it.
Yeah, do it.
Well, first.
Yeah, you're first.
Joe's gonna be first.
Unreleased, by the way. Unreleased, but I want to see you two knock this back. I'm excited now.
Have you do it?
You pull the, you know, that
thing. Up to you. Whichever one is more similar to a comp bar.
Are you pausing today, are you? Just pausing.
I'm only going up to 227.5 today. Pausing. No higher. How was that shit? Was it actually?
I'm dreading this now.
Does it smell good?
It smells like a drumstick.
Does it actually smell like a drumstick?
Virgin.
What it was meant to look like.
What this. That's what it's meant to look like, and this is what it looks like. Words of wisdom here as to why I will potentially fail on Saturday, or not potentially, but why I would if I did. And he thinks it's because I'm shit at commands, and I agree.
Can't be told what to do.
Can't be, yeah. I struggle with authority.
You will respect my authority.
There's two commands. There's two commands. You can do one, but two.
Yeah, see, look, pressing, I like that, so it's a good command because I like doing that. Rack when I'm told.
I mean, that's the bit like, who do you think you are, you know what I mean?
I like to rack when I want to. Yeah, I guess you like summer fruits, yeah?
I haven't tried it yet.
Yeah, mate, summer fruits body fuel. Code Baker20 at checkout, get yours. guys, if you're watching this, forget his bench, it doesn't mean anything. I'm on 980k on TikTok. I'm nearly at a million. Let's go, man. Go follow if you're not.
No, here's another question, because I'm also not used to this. So now you get to warm up at the back before your flight.
Yeah.
How long do you get to warm up for?
That's the thing. There's no
you don't get that long.
It depends.
So if there's not going to be a lot of people in my weight class, is there?
No, of course you've got to wait for bench pressing.
Huh?
You've got to wait for all the squats to go. Yeah.
There's no squats on the day. There's no squats. It's only two lifts, deadlift and bench.
Oh, is it a push pull?
Single lift championships per deadlift bench.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And I checked it, so it's first thing in the morning, 9 o'clock, it's men's raw under 90 kilo, then quarter past 10, it's men's raw over. Yeah, overs.
So, yeah, but the thing is, there might not be
early.
It is early. That's my one concern, by the way, is how early it is. I've never been very early in my life. I might go to put 4 in the morning and start chewing food.
Generally, you don't want to change anything. When you change something, go wrong. Just don't change anything. Why do you need to?
I suppose I don't need to.
Literally, get one good fat meal in you. Like you usually would,
obviously. And I think breakfast.
One big fat meal in with you.
What, in the morning? I usually whack in a brekkie, but I don't want to whack in a brekkie too early, though.
I think, oh, I've got absolutely pound food like I never ever do. Why
would
you do that?
Yeah. Just perform the way you normally do, yeah.
Exactly the same. Yeah.
Oh, scary! Oh, shiver my timbers! Shut up, man!
Guys, Mike's going up to 250 now, and I feel sad because I'm not allowed to. I want to go heavy too. So I'm going to have to settle for 230 for another single in a sec.
So I'm on strike from tuning out. Right. I'm disrespecting it as a food because he disrespected my scrambled egg. He said earlier, scrambled egg shit. So now I'm never eating tuna again.
I don't need an answer. It's the wrong way. I caught him so good then.
What did you do? In the lap?
In the... I just hit him in the ribs.
He's having 5 minutes.
So sexy, Joe. Wow. Yo, nice belly hair, man. Try trimming that shitty scruff.
Yo, guys, what's up? We're in Manchester. We compete tomorrow. Shit's moving quick. I just got here about 20 minutes ago. I've got to go and weigh in shortly. I've got to weigh in between 3 and 4 p.m. today. And then it's just come back to the hotel, rest, eat a lot. Not too much, not want to change anything too much, but eat, rest, get some extra sleep in, and be up nice and early tomorrow morning to just get my body ready and get primed. That British record's mine, I'm speaking it into existence, just watch. I'm excited, man, excited, can't wait. Yeah, obviously I know I haven't really brought you guys along too much recently, I'm sorry, man, I've been trying to juggle a lot of stuff. But for those of you that do know or don't know, if you follow me on socials, you'll know that in 11 days, 10 days, I step away from work. And I'll be full-time with my gym, with content, with lifting, and with putting out videos. So, it's exciting stuff, and I can't wait. This bed looks alright, isn't it? What do you think, guys? a little room tour, or what? Should we have a little room tour? So we've got, obviously we've got me looking beautiful. We've got a little, let me turn the screen around. We've got a little TV here. A little, I'm still gonna, I don't know what the hell I'm watching right now. I'll just turn the TV on when I come in. Got a nice little side mirror there. Shouldn't have turned the angle then, but I'll get in trouble for that. Editor's gonna be upset. Oh, I don't know why I'm zooming in. This is not going well. Great room tour. We got obviously the hotline for the bitches. I've got a lamp that looks like it doesn't work. Oh, I've got an iron though. I may need to iron my t-shirts. I think I bundled them up in the bag. And then, yeah, I mean, that's it really. It's not too bad. Got a little bit of a, is that PG tips I spot there? Can you hoodies. Bit of a kettle, bit of a cup of tea, isn't there? Obviously we've got some art. Looks good. Wow. Amazing. Have I got lights in here or what? Do the lights come on? Oh. Is that it? Oh. Could have given me a couple more lights, like. They've done me over the lighting. Have I got AC? How to operate in room air? Oh, I have. What's this? Oh, it's my piss box. The fuck, bruv? I'm not fitting in that. I'm not fitting in fuck.
Bruv, I'm taller than the shower, and I'm taller than the door.
Oh, okay. Oh, I'm so beautiful, Lord. It's difficult being this beautiful, you know. I've got the green on green today, guys. Don't know how I feel about it, we'll see.
Back from the weigh-in, weighed in. I've actually lost some weight, which I wasn't expecting. But hey-ho, then again, it could just be taking my clothes off, because I'm a big dude. My clothes, I guess, are pretty heavy. So yeah, weigh-in done. Back in the hotel room now, hungry. So hungry. I haven't eaten since this morning. What did I eat this morning? I had a full English, but it was a bit naff. What did I have? I had two sausage, two egg, two hash browns. Basically a small meal for me. Oh no, then again, I also had a sausage, bacon and egg sandwich too. Yeah, maybe I'm wrong, maybe I'm lying. But I'm hungry now. What time is it? It is 4:02 p.m. So my son's in my background there. And I have just ordered from the Trap Kitchen in Manchester. I've seen this place on socials before, but there isn't one by me to use. So I've just taken advantage of ordered from Trap Kitchen. What we got? We got the chicken combo, which is barbecue chicken, Spanish rice, and buttered corn. Then we got a Coke. Then we've also got another chicken combo, which is jerk chicken, mac and cheese, and an Oreo topped waffle. I cannot wait. Yeah, it did cost me £33. I just spent £33 on food for myself. Am I a fat fucker?
Yeah, it's nice.
So, still waiting for my food to arrive, but I did order some grocery stuff. Would you like to see what we've got to keep me fueled? Let's go. You ready for this? So, starting off, got the classics. More chocolate flat. Milk chocolate flapjacks. Bad boy. Obviously the standard. Water. Another bottle of water. Oh. Little sugar there. Got some pop, because you always gotta have pop. Got a 6-pack of McCoy's. 2 cheese onion sandwiches. Some bananas with carbs. And some sweets for glucose. Keep me energized. Ready for tomorrow? So, oh, these flapjacks are good, bro. Oh yeah. I think I might just eat these all night. But yeah, still waiting for my food when it gets here. I'll start answering some questions. Right, I'm gonna start digging into my food and while I'm eating, like I said, I might answer some of your guys' questions. Oh, this looks so good. I don't even know where to start, man. Let's try this mac and cheese. Oh. Nah. 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 That's illegal. Bro, that's illegal. Only downfall. They sent me a Coke Zero. I don't do zero. I'm all in. It's as simple as that. Right, what we got here then? So it looks like we got some. Oh, wait. It's just falling off. No. Nah. I will move to Manchester just for this. I will move here just for this. This is crazy. I have got a napkin, you know. Yeah. Right, so let me unlock my phone and I'll start going through some questions from you guys. So this is from John, or Mr. Saucy. And John says, when did you start lifting and what was your bench pilot at the point? So I started lifting when I was like 22, about 6 years ago now. That was when I started lifting. And I want to say the first weight that I ever benched was about 105 kilo. So I had very good beginner gains. I need to get into some more mac and cheese, bro. Oh, this rice is crazy. Benjamin asks, should I wear my belt to bench? I think using a belt to bench is super beneficial. It makes your brace a bit higher, meaning that it kind of declines your RAM a tiny bit. Ultimately, meaning the movement is going to be easier for you. I think it helps with stability too, and just a lot tighter brace. I really enjoy it. I personally enjoy benching with a belt. Well, yo, I mean, I'm going to answer questions, but I'm also going to enjoy this. This is so good. I'm glad I ordered this, bro. I picked the right place. Yeah. It's mac and cheese. This is different. Oh, my God. Go on. God, I'm in heaven. Give me that back right now. Thank you. Jerk chicken. I wouldn't call that jerk chicken. It's more like a cinnamon. Not in a jerk. I mean, it's good. It's nice flavour. It's well seasoned, but it's not jerk chicken. It's like a cinnamon flavoured sweet chicken. Ahmed asks, what's the best source of protein? Is there a difference if someone is bulking or cutting? I mean, yeah, there's always a difference. If you're bulking, your body's more fueled. You're going to get stronger easier. Vice versa. You're going to gain more mass quicker. If you're cutting, it's more difficult to gain mass. And you may find that you also lack the energy and endurance that you had when you were bulking. I suppose it's not really about the best source. I suppose it's about preference. For me, my favourite source of protein is my food. I still drink like 4 or 5 shakes a day. AppliedNutrition.uk, called Baker20, go get yours. For me, I like getting my protein from my food, mainly from eggs. I love egg. I love chicken. So, yeah. Dan Snow said, could you do a little education session on protein, how much equivalent to body weight, etc.? So the standard that most people know is that you aim for a gram of protein per pound of body weight, yeah? So if you weigh 300 pounds, you should be eating 300 grams of protein daily. And that's not necessarily to grow. That's just to kind of maintain or have a good maintenance. If you're asking me, you need to be taking, I'd say, an average of 40 grams of protein an hour for about 8 hours a day. And that sounds crazy, but that's what I try to do. obviously, I'm a heavy guy, but I do that because I feel like that benefits me the most. What's the biggest tip you can give to young lifters, said Gabe? Stop looking at the number, because the most commonly asked question I get is, bro, is this a good lift for this age and this body weight? Don't even worry about that. Just worry about how hard you're working, bro. Because the numbers don't mean nothing. The numbers will come over time. Everything comes in time. Just question your ethic and how hard you're working. If you're working hard, then that's all that matters. Don't worry about the number. For you guys that don't know, the editor's been sat there watching this, just hearing me go, In fact, I'm pretty sure whoever's in the room opposite me thinks I'm probably whacking one off, but I'm not. You know when you get mad about how good But this mac and cheese is making me angry. It's that good. Janik asks, Mr. Reaper, what is the one meal that you love to eat that's high on calories and protein? I mean, if we're going all out, if we're talking just absolutely all out, what's my favourite cheat meal? It's got to be Five Guys. It's got to be Five Guys, because I'll go there and I'll have like a large triple cheeseburger and a bacon cheese dog and a large fries, and I just send it. Yeah, I'm not even going to lie. Next up, we got Aiden. So Aiden McNicholas said, do you ever plan on hopping on a cycle in the future and chasing down an all-time world record? The simple, fast answer to that is yes, 100%. Yep. When, I don't know. I do think it will probably be before 2024. I think I'll hop on at some point this year. I just don't know when. We'll see. But yeah, 100%. I think it would be a shame for me to not chase my potential. So, Dieti DMB said, can you please humble me? Bro, you guys, do you know how many of these I get a day? I get about 50, 60 of these a day. Saying, bro, can you please put me in the graveyard? It's not a good place to be, you know. Like, that's not what it's about. So, I'm afraid not, sir. I can't, no. Harry just asked me, are you competing at the BPU Brits tomorrow? To answer your question, yes. By the time you see this video, I will have already done it. So, AK Leaf said, yo, bro, first of all, you're a massive inspiration. And keep up the work. Thank you very much, bro, and I will. I was wondering what really boosted your bench press and your overall lifts in the gym. Consistency, bro, more than anything. Fueling my body, eating, getting the calories in, and just being consistent. There's no secret recipe. There's no magic thing that people do. Ultimately, some people just work harder than others, and that's it. You've just got to work hard, bro. Astalos Valiant said, what will be your ideal weights for your attempts tomorrow? So, I'm opening with 227.5. And I'm going to go probably from there, depending on how that feels. I'll go either 247.5, which will be a new record, new British record, and then send it again, probably go 260. If I do 227.5, doesn't move the way I want it to, but I still get the rep, I might then go 237.5 and then 247.5 and just settle for the record and not try and, like, you know, send it crazy. But yeah, just going to see how I feel. You got to remember, I'm not coming into this too cocky. I don't want to. This is it's a brand new sport to me. It's a sport people love and take seriously. And ultimately, it's something that I'm brand new to. I've practiced commands once, so I've got to be careful. And I've really got to take my time. And if I can get a British record on first try of asking, that's more than enough. I should be happy with that. So, Chris Moore said, have you got any tips for building big fuck off shoulders? All I've ever done is the same two movements, and that is barbell shoulder press. That's it. An upright barbell row. I never really ever did lat raises, ever. I never really did like side lat rolls or anything like that. It was always just big upright rows and shrugs and shoulder press, and that's it, man. That's all I've ever done, literally. Raza asked, do you take gearing? If so, what? I don't know. So that was an easy question. No, I never took gear. Ever. So there's no real advice I can give you, I'm afraid, bro. You should do cameos. Talk about that. Callum just said, still at Foundry tomorrow, bro. I mean, I will be. By the time you see this, you'll have already met me there, bro. So, yeah. Are you bulking right now to increase your bench? Said Newman. What has been your experience with bench strength? How it relates to bulking cutting? So I find that it's not necessarily the amount of food I eat. It's the food that I eat. It's the quality of the food that I eat that will usually decide how good my bench press is going to be on the day. That's what I tend to find. If I have a really good carb load the day before, I tend to perform really well the day after. And that's just how it goes for me. Do I think you need to have a super high body weight to have a really good bench press? No, not at all. There's dudes out there that weigh 105. Look at Mike, my training partner. 107 kilo, benches 275. Do you know what I mean? You don't need to be super heavy to bench super heavy. Ibrahim asks, what is the worst thing about being so big? And I can answer this easy. The fact that I can't go on fucking rides. Like, go to Alton Towers, I can't fit on anything. Go to a theme park, can't fit on nothing. I can't even get the shit over my shoulders, over my chest. So yeah, that is 100% the biggest and most annoying thing, is that I can't experience stuff like that. But you know, it's a pretty simple sacrifice. Do you know what I mean? So, right, that's all the questions. So I'm going to dig into the rest of this food. I'll catch you guys in a bit. I'll probably catch you in a little... I'll check in with you guys a little later on after I've relaxed, let my food settle. Probably made the TikTok. And yeah, back in a bit. I'm finished. That food was out of this fucking world good. Look, let me show you. Whoa, camera's gone quick. Let me show you. Bruv, I absolutely murked it. I've even opened the flapjacks. Do you know what I mean? Like, right, what time is it now? Let's have a look at the time, guys. 17:23. So I'm going to give it about 3 hours, and I'm going to get another meal in, probably a couple them two cheese sandwiches there. Maybe a bag of crisps and some flapjacks, maybe a banana. Might get bananas for the morning, to be honest, but yeah. Oh, I'm finessed. Also. Chloe asked the question, but I didn't see the question, so I'd already stopped recording. So what's the key to getting past the weight you're stuck failing? So the key, and 9 times out of 10, is if you stop failing it, it's probably a mental game, I'm not going to lie. 9 times out of 10, when you're attempting a weight, it's probably because you can do it. But it's whether your mind is in the place, or whether you've got that mind control to be able to make it happen. Also, again, let's get the hair out. It's whether you've got that mind control to say, do you know what, I'm going to make this happen. Regardless of how I feel, and regardless of how my body feels, I'm committed, I'm going to do it. A lot of the time, that's where people struggle, is that mental blockade is enough to not allow them to do it. So, I've had it where I've had mental blockades and failed lifts, then came back the week later and done it easy. You just have to be able to mentally overcome it first. If you can mentally overcome it, then you've already done it. You've already done the lift. Good morning. Worst sleep ever. Literally, worst sleep ever. Bunged up. Just such a shit sleep, bro. I woke up about 7-8 times, I don't know, probably. Could be more, I don't know. I just woke up so much. Couldn't sleep properly, couldn't sleep all the way through. At all. I don't know what's wrong with me, man. Just could not sleep for shit. But yeah, I tried to go to sleep early. I did say to you guys I'd check in with you, but I didn't. I tried to go to sleep at like 9 PM. And then I pretty much just lay here like this for hours and couldn't sleep. And then when I finally did fall asleep, I was just on and off. So yeah. But either way, no excuses, bruv. No excuses, no bullshit. Today's the day. Just beef for some breakfast, so I have just beef for a little full English, not a lot, just a couple sausages, 2 sausage, 2 egg, bit of scrambled egg, 2 hash brown, no bacon. I wasn't in the mood for bacon this morning. some beans. What else did I have? Oh, and 2 Weetabix, that's all I've had. I don't want to overdo it this morning. I don't want to be too full. So yeah, had some food. I'm done now, that's it. I'm just chilling in my room. It's about 7:40. So I've got about 1 hour and 20 minutes before I need to kind of start to get ready and go. Sorry that you had to hear that, but what must go. So yeah, about 1 hour and 20 minutes before I need to start to focus on getting ready. So I'm probably going to lie here for an hour and watch some powerlifting motivation videos. There is no tomorrow. Mark's on the way, Luke's on the way, so yeah, man. Ooh, it's go time. It's go time.
Why have you drawn attention to all of this instead of shying away from it?
Show me what you've got, Slim Shady. Let me zoom on that. Ooh. Okay. That's not bad at all.
Your turn, Baker.
I mean, I'm...
Your turn, Baker.
You have got to step up to that.
Yeah.
He's a lefty, he's a lefty.
He's a lefty, I got old horses.
So we're winding up. Did I beat Mike?
Boy, one.
I saw Mike's second.
Yeah, you look at Chris. I would. Camera's on, Luke. We're expecting good stuff here.
They just run it.
Oh, we're like running.
What's he missing at the machine?
Ooh, I mean, to be fair,
dude, that, be the
that was a bang. That might be the best. He said. I mean, that was fucking, yeah.
I really gave that one.
That was a bit vicious, mate. That's. Oh, shit. Hey, that was vicious. Is there any more money in there? And have you got any more change?
No, he's got no money left.
Fuck's sake, man. That was a fucking bomb, that was, I'm not gonna lie.
I thought I hit it really hard.
That was a bomb.
I just had my ego.
Quite impressed with that. That was a bomb.
I looked really good there.
Did it?
Yeah,
your punch looked really good, it just apparently wasn't.
I think it was that hard, the machine couldn't register it. So it hit the max score and then started again.
Yeah, he's right, yeah. That's what happened.
It is, yeah. Fucking really.
Yo, guys, so it is Sunday 14th. So it's a day after the Single Lift Championships in Manchester. And I just want to talk you guys through the day yesterday. Close out this video. I opened yesterday on 227.5 kilo, which is 500 pounds. Super easy lift. Moved really fast, stupid fast. And it's a learning, definitely that's my first learning curve straight away, is that I shouldn't doubt my own power, because I opened super light and didn't need to at all, really. It was comfortable, it was easy. All in all, it was something that I should have definitely just done in a warm-up room. I don't know why I went out and chose 227.5 as an opener. I guess it's because it was my first comp, just to shake off the nerves, shake off the pre-jitters, and to just, you know, get a lift under my belt. But for future, and I say for future because I do intend to compete again, I will open at a higher weight, possibly around 250, 247.5, 255, something like that. So I opened on 227.5, really easy. In the federation that I've been competing under, in the ABPU, there's only two commands rather than three, like classic and most powerlifting feds, where you get start, press and rack. In this fed there is only press and rack, so you can start when you like. So yeah, got two white lights, one red on the first rep on the opener, so either way the rep counted all in. And then I moved on to 247.5 kilo for my second press, which is a British record. So 245 is the current natural British record, and I intended to, with the second lift, set a new record of 247.5, so a 5 pound record. So I approached the lift the same, so I approached the first one. It went up really easy, weight was really easy, power was evident. If there's one thing I could say, is that I think I have underestimated my raw power. Possibly because I've been benching in wraps and you know, straps and sleeves and all that, you know, all that malarkey in the gym for so long. I've never really tested my raw power too well, and I've obviously never powerlifted before, and I've also never competed to a comp standard or done comp bench before. So again, learning curve. But yeah, 247.5 moved really well. Really happy with how it moved. It was quick. It was speedy off my chest. It was a really good rep. Looked like maybe RPE 3-4. Rep wasn't given. It was two reds, one white, and it wasn't given because, I'll tell you why. I went and queried, so I queried immediately with the ref as to why it wasn't given, and the ref told me that it was because I had sunk after the press command, So what this means to give those of you that might not know an understanding, because I'll tell you this much, I didn't know, and I didn't even know it was a thing before going into the actual press on the day. That just shows how little my knowledge was, I suppose. What it means is I've came down to my chest, and they've given me the press command from here. As they've given me the press command, I've sunk a little lower before pressing. Now, once you're given the press command, you cannot sink any lower. So upon press, you can only go upward. You can't go down at all. And so they made a fair call on my second press, and on that 247.5 first attempt, they made a fair call, and they were right. Yeah, I did minimally, but I did go down a bit on that attempt. So obviously in my head, I had committed to the third being 247.5 as well, because I just really wanted that record. And yes, it was an easy weight. I knew it was comfortable, so I thought just master the basic of this easy weight. And then I'll get a fourth lift, because the benefit is if you set a record, you're then given the opportunity for a fourth lift to push that boat out and increase the size of that record. When again, and this time, the kind of little tips that I was given before going into the press was to just sink, was to let the bar just sink into me as much as it can and then press. Put it down and sunk it more than the initial attempt, definitely. Sunk it as much as I pretty much felt I could. And pressed it again super convincingly with great power. Racked it, followed the commands correctly, and was given two reds, one white again. Now, I'm not going to speak too much on this. There are hundreds of people that disagree with the decision. There are also plenty of people that agree with the decision. So, you know, both sides have got ample points for their arguments. Obviously, if you're going to ask me, there's immediate bias applied because it's me. I feel it was extremely harsh, not giving the third. If you watch the camera back on the video that I posted on Instagram from Head On, I don't feel like I dipped again. I don't feel like I dipped again at all. And if I did sink anymore, it was extremely minimal and the judging was very strict. But at the same time, it is a record attempt, and so the judging needs to be strict. However, it would have been given on another day. I suppose that's just what it is different refs, different day, different refs, same day. It would have been a new British record, and that's okay. It is what it is. And I suppose that's just the reality of it, is that it could have gone either way. It was a 50-50 thing, and it didn't go the way that I wanted it to, and that's okay. One thing that did go my way was I got to display just how powerful I am, raw, as a natural presser, and it's exciting to know now that that's under my belt and I've got so much more in me. Because that 247, it wasn't challenging. And I say this with full confidence to really put some competition out there. I hope you guys are working. I really do. I hope you're working hard. Because that 245 is baby food. Baby food. Yeah? I'm going to eat that on an opener. And then I'm coming for the all-time UK. I'm going to eat that too. I promise you that. I really am. That's the goal. That's the plan. I'm coming through it all. I want it all. There's not a part of my fibre that doesn't want it all. I do this out of love. I train out of love. It's my escape. It's my passion. It's everything. My discipline, my commitment. It's everything to me. I really, really do want it all now. I had a taste for blood yesterday. It's the first time I got to taste it. It's the first time I got to put myself out there on a platform, on a stage, and to experience the surrounding and to experience what it's like. Fuck, is it fun? Wow, it is fun. Now, I'm not saying I'm going to commit the rest of my life to powerlifting or commit even the next 6 months to powerlifting, but what I'm saying is I'm going to be working hard in the shadows, in the gym, still making my content, nothing's going to change, still doing my dumb shit, but I'm going to start factoring in a lot of that comp standard bench. I'm going to start mastering it and perfecting it. And I'm going to start coming for those records real soon. That natural record, that'll be mine before the end of the year, 100%. And I say that willingly. I know I'm going to make it happen. It's only a matter of time. So, look, didn't go the way I wanted it to, and that's okay. It is no fault of the refs. The refs called what they saw in the moment. And yes, it was very harsh, very harsh. And it may have been given any other day. And it might have been given if it wasn't a record attempt. Maybe it was just stricter judging because it was a record attempt. But it is what it is, and that's the decision that was made. The only thing that we can do now is redemption and redeem ourselves and go back and show that we've learned from that mistake. We've mastered the hold. We've mastered the press, and that there's, we make it undeniable. So I just want to say thank you to Emma, who's the head of ABPU and BPU, for getting me involved on such short notice. You definitely didn't have to do that. Thank you to the people that I met on the day, the refs, the volunteers, the judges. You guys were very welcoming, and just all around nice people. Thank you to Fat Muscle Coaching, Sam. Thank you to Sam Drosnick. Oh, I've lost lighting. Thank you to everyone. And most of all, more than anyone, thank you to Mike, Mike Rabb. He's my best mate. He's a fucking legend. The guy's an animal. And he's got a mindset that matches mine. He really has. But more than anything, he's an absolute fucking demon. And he's got some raw fucking fire inside of him. And I really do hope that he gets the recognition that he deserves soon. And then finally, thank you to these guys. Applied Nutrition UK, man. Thank you to Silverback Gymwear. Honestly, the best sponsors I could have ever asked for. Just unreal. The support you've shown me so far in such a short time, through products you've supplied to me for, you know, for giveaway, for, you know, gym meet. I mean, the gym meet yesterday, I haven't even spoken on that. The gym meet yesterday was amazing. So after the comp, I drove down to Stoke, Newcastle-under-Lyme, did a gym meet in Foundry. You know, 30, 40, maybe even 50 kids turned up. And I say kids because it was the younger generation, but it was amazing to know that that is my audience, because that's who I'm inspiring. I'm inspiring the future generation of lifters, and that is so cool to think about. And it just motivates me even more to keep going and to push boundaries. But yeah, thank you to Silverback. Thank you to Applied Nutrition. You guys supplied me with stuff to give away to those kids, and their faces were beaming. People were so happy. And obviously, the benefit of that is hopefully we've secured customers for life with those. They were super happy, man. And it's just, it was just a great vibe all around. It was a great vibe, man. But yeah, thank you so much to my sponsors. Both incredible. Head to appliednutrition.uk and use code BAKER20 at checkout. Save yourself 20% on the best protein on the market. I don't just say that because I'm sponsored by them. I've used it for 3 years. It is the best protein on the market. I'm telling you, because I have never seen a protein that doesn't clump like this. No shaker, no grid, no ball. I can put this stuff in a glass and swirl it and it won't clump. Like, that's how good this stuff is. And then not only that, but we've got Abe, best pre-workout on the market. And we've got Body Fuel, which basically just puts Prime in fucking tap water range. Do you know what I mean? So, head over there. And then not only that, but Silverback Gymwear, come on. Who doesn't want to look like a fucking gorilla while they're training? Like, is it even a difficult question? Just be realistic for a sec. It's not, is it? We all want to look absolutely dense and wham when training. And Silverback, mate, they just make some of the cleanest, sickest designs for gym wear that I've ever seen. So go to the link in my Instagram bio or go to the link on this YouTube description and save yourself 10% at checkout if you follow the link on Silverback Clothing. Look, guys, it's been a blast. I know it's been a long video, and if you've sat all the way through it, I'm really grateful. back to normal. Back to full content, multiple videos coming. I did a little shoot with Silverback last week or the week before, depending on when you're watching this, and that video's coming. We attempted 310 kilo in that video, failed miserably. Shouldn't have told you that yet, because it was a bit surprising in the video. But yeah, Silverback video coming, and much more to come. Okay, this is just the beginning of a long content creation period for me. So I love you all. Thank you so much for support. Thank you for 1 million followers on TikTok. Incredible. It is down to every single person that likes, shares, comments, follows me. It means the world. All of your guys' support means the world. And the reach and the opportunities and everything that is coming to me through that is because of you guys. And I owe it to you. So thank you so much, man. And also, because the gym meet went so well, we're going to do another one. So I don't know where yet. I'm going to put some feelers out on Instagram, get an idea. But gym meet was incredible. So let's run up another gym meet. I'll put it on Instagram tonight. You might see it over the next couple of days. You might have already seen it. But either way, love you guys. Big love, man. Reap it out.